Welcome to Dark Horizon Creations. I'm Mike, and tonight we're taking a look at the Spartan Gungnir from Halo, the Spartan Collection Series 2. Now, if you hadn't already, please follow, like, and subscribe to my social media accounts on Facebook, Instagram, and YouTube. We're up to 260 subscribers on YouTube. Thank you guys so much for the support. It means a lot. I'm about to fall asleep on you guys because I've never done a video review at night. I've always done them in the daytime, but because I've gotten studio lighting in here, I can do reviews anytime I want. That's really cool, in addition to the upgraded camera and stuff like that. So, Spartan Gungnir is a really unique set of armor. If you don't know anything about the in-universe history of it, it first appeared in Halo Reach. Gungnir was a project devised by Section 3 of ONI, Office of Naval Intelligence, to supplement the Mark V Mjolnir armor system. And the primary purpose for Gungnir was to support the use of the M6 Galilean Spartan laser system. The helmet consists of a fully enclosed helmet. You know, it's got that visor that you see up there in the upper right-hand corner of the packaging. And it has no external viewport on it. It has that camera that you see in the upper left-hand side, and that provides the wearer with complete situational awareness around them, and it displays everything on a internal display in the visor. It also has a unique set of shoulder pads, which were not only utilized by the Spartans, UNSC Army soldiers also derived a set of armored shoulder pads from the Gungnir armor. If you're wondering about the name Gungnir, that is the name of Odin's spear. That's where they got the name for the armor from. There, a lot of the names and stuff that they use in Halo come from mythology, particularly Norse mythology and things like that. And then, of course, the Spartans, they use that from Greek history. You can see in the package included is the 5 additional sets of hands, as well as the MK50 sidekick, 10mm sidearm, and the M41 spanker. It is a surface-to-surface medium anti-vehicle rocket system. It fires 102mm high explosive round. The thing that really gets me, and, you know, the people who created this stuff at Bungie or 343, whoever, I'm thinking Bungie done this, there's a couple instances where they gave different military equipment, weapons, vehicles, and things the same designation. The first one being the M6 Magnum, okay? Then you also have the M6 Galilean Spartan Laser. You have the M41 LAG, light anti-aircraft gun mounted on the Warthog. You also have the M41 Spanker rocket launcher that you see in front of you. So go figure. If they had consulted with, you know, retired military personnel, that is, you know, something that they would not have done. They would have given each its own specific designation. And those of you that are prior service, you know what I'm talking about. Those of you who haven't served, you might not completely understand it, but, you know, in the military, everything has a alphanumeric designation. Everything, including people. You have your own serial number. So to see, you know, multiple items in the Halo universe with the same alphanumeric designation, right off of the bat, you know that people didn't know what they were doing. And they weren't paying attention to details there. So you can see that the Series 2 figures have the same packaging as the Series 1. Really nice window box there. Minimized banners going around the perimeter of the box with the Halo logo at the bottom. The title of the figure at the top, and then Spartan Collection on the left-hand side. On the side of the box, you have an image of the Gungnir Spartan. And then down at the bottom, your original UNSC logo. On the back, you have your obligatory product shots. Now, the Series 1, there was only 4 figures. In Series 2, there's 5. And the reason there's 5 is the Master Chief is a repack. The only new figures in here are the other figures. Jerome, Emil, Spartan Mark 5B repaint, and then the Spartan Gungnir. And If I'm not mistaken, Series 3 also includes a Master Chief repack with the grapple hook and the VK-78 Commando rifle. I really believe they made a mistake doing that. You know, we don't need multiple repacks of the Master Chief. That was a wonderful opportunity for them to include a completely new figure or a different figure that we haven't seen, like Noble 6. That's one of the figures that everyone is asking for. So I think that they, you know, made a mistake with the repacks of the Master Chief. And, you know, really what they should do, you know, is just create weapon packs, you know, with different weapons and accessories. You know, even if they're for specific figures like the Chief, you know, so be it. But we don't need to, you know, put a repack of a figure in every single assortment. So what we're going to do now is we're going to pause the video. We're going to remove the figure from the packaging and come back and see what he's all about. All right, guys, we're back with the Spartan Gungnir from Halo, the Spartan Collection Series 2. And really cool looking figure. You can see I got his visor snapped onto him. And you can take that off if you want to. And that's what his head sculpt is going to look like. And really nice figure. He has on a nice tight ball joint. Forward and lateral movement there at the shoulder. Really tight, tight butterfly joint. Forward and lateral movement at the thigh, rotation, double jointed knees, really tight joints, really tight ankle joint, tight toe joints there. And his torso is on a really nice tight ball joint. A lot of cool detail in this figure all the way around. They did a lot of weathering on this figure. Very similar to the Spartan Mark V that you see in the background. Really, really cool figure. One of the things I want to point out, the side panel here, this pulls out and you turn it around and it's got that peg in there for your sidearm. You can see what the MK50 sidekick looks like. Then on the back, got another one, turn around, push into place. And that will be for the M41 or rifle. Let's take a look at it real quick. A lot of nice detail in there. I like the way this looks. Again, it's made out of that soft rubber, but I think they did a really great job with it overall. Looks really cool. There's the port plug in here. And one of the things you'll find is that these sections with the peg, that will come out unless you glue it in place. I use Gorilla Glue to glue mine in place. So there you have the Spartan Gungnir from Halo, the Spartan Collection, Series 2. Really cool action figure. No quality control issues there. I think Jazzware did a really great job with these. So I hope you guys enjoyed the review. Stay tuned. There's more to come.